This Torah class is brought to you by TorahAnytime.com.
One of the famous questions, it's about Hatan Bar Mitzvah, who became Bar Mitzvah in the middle of the days of the Omer. He started when he was a child, and then a week later, 2 weeks later, in the middle of Sefirat HaOmer, he turned Bar Mitzvah. Can he continue count with the Berachot? He was counting every day, he was very careful. Ben Chacham Yisamach Av, Yanik V'Hakim, Baruch Hashem, he started to count the Omer, and he was very careful to count every day, didn't miss anything. But now he turned Bar Mitzvah. Question is if he can continue with the Berachot. What's the safek? Why there is a question? There is a Gemara. Gemara Masechet Rosh Hashanah, Daf Kaf Het. Gemara says over there, Gemara talks about Matzah. If a person ate Matzah while he was Shote, patur min ha-mitzvot. Kefa'uhu ve'achal matzah. Gemara says, kefa'uhu man, ilima, kefa'uhu ahra'ah. Which means, it's a chas v'shalom, there is such a situation, a person has a bad spirit, comes to him from time to time. And when he has this bad spirit, he's crazy. He's completely not there. He doesn't know anything he does. He doesn't know left and right, nothing. He's not there. Then hours later, he gets back to himself. This bad spirit leaves him, and he gets back to himself, and he's aware of everything. This is called in a Gemara, Aitim Halim, Aitim Shoteh. Sometimes he's well, sometimes he's Shoteh. What's the status of Shoteh? Shoteh, Patur Mikol HaMitzvot. So now we're talking about Leil HaSeder. He was sitting in Leil HaSeder. The beginning of the night, he was Bar Minan Shoteh. But he started the Seder together with everybody. He did Kadesh, Orchatz, Karpas, Yahatz, Magid, Rochza, Motzi, Matzah, he ate a Matzah, he did Shalosh Kosot. Until after Birkat HaMazon. He did three Kosot out of the four cups of the wine. And then, in the middle of the Seder, after Birkat HaMazon, he woke up. Bad spirit left him, Baruch Hashem, now he's aware of everything. And he's asking you, what did he do? Did he eat a Matzah? He didn't eat a Matzah? And you're telling him he did everything properly. He did motzi matzah, he did korech, he did maror, he did everything. Was he yotzei dechava or not? Says the Gemara over there, no, he's not yotzei dechava. Why? While he was eating, at that time, he was shoteh, patur min ha-mitzvot. Now that he's back to himself, and he has his pikeah, he has the right knowledge, now he understands what he's doing, now he's hayav to start from the beginning. Starts from Kaddish. He'll do Kiddush again, he'll do the Agadah again, he'll eat the matzah again with the berachot. He's going to say another two berachot. Asher kedeshanu mitzvah asher al achilat matzah, al achilat maror. Why? All the mitzvot that he did while he was shoteh, that's called zman pitur, is not yotzei dechava. And now that he's bardat, now he's hayav, now he's obligated to do the mitzvot, now he can do it, now he fulfilled the mitzvah, and it's going to be yotzei dechava. We're learning from this Gemara, yesod. What's the yesod comes out of the Gemara? If a person did something while he was patur, he's not yotze. So now, katan is patur min ha-mitzvot also. Katan patur mikol ha-mitzvot kulam. He counted the omer, midin chinuch. We're mechanech, the katan, we're educating him, we're training him to do the mitzvot. But he's patur min ha-torah, he doesn't have to. Once he turns bar mitzvah, now it becomes obligated. So all the first days that he was counting the omer, he was patur. That doesn't count for him. He's not yotze dechava. He should... Now that he became Bar Mitzvah, now he's starting to do the Mitzvah. According to Baal Chol Gedolot, that we mentioned last week, that says, Sefirat HaOmer Ba'inan Timimot. What's Timimot according to Bahag? Timimot means that he's not going to miss even one day. All the days are supposed to be counted. If he missed one day, he lost the Mitzvah according to Bahag. So this Katan, this child, that was in the beginning of Sefirat HaOmer, Patur. So let's say, a week of Sefirat HaOmer, he was a child. And then he turned Bar Mitzvah. That first week, he was Patur Min HaMitzvah, it's considered that he missed it. Even if he counted the days of the Omer, but he was not obligated. And as we learned from the Gemara, if he was Patur, even if he did it, he's not Yotzei Dechava. So although he counted the days, but it's not considered for him that he fulfilled the Mitzvah. And therefore, according to Baruch Gedolot, now the question arises, can he start to or continue saying the Berachot on Sefirat HaOmer? So again, what's his situation? He was a katan in the beginning of the Sfira, and he turned bar mitzvah in the middle of Sfirat HaOmer. The first days when that he was counting while he was a katan, he was patur, and he's not obligated, he's not yotzer with these days. From that day that he became bar mitzvah and on, now he's hayav. So now, can he start from the beginning, from the middle of Sfirat HaOmer to count? Wehiyuv? That's the question. According to Rabbeinu Tam, who says that each night it's a mitzvah by itself, and even if a person missed a night, or even a few nights, he didn't miss the mitzvah, he can still continue with the beracha. There's no question here also. I don't care that this Bahatan bar mitzvah lost the first few days. As long, every day it's a new mitzvah. So, whatever he is, in the middle of Sfirat HaOmer, he's going to count every day, mitzvah by itself. That's according to Rabbeinu Tam. But the question is according to Ba'al HaGedolot. It's not that simple. Why? Because if you remember, on Halachot Purim, we learned a very interesting halacha. There's a machloket on Halachot Purim. If Katan is Motzi Gadol, Yedei Chova with a Megillah reading. Why I would say Katan Motzi Gadol? Gadol is obligated, Katan is Patur. Comes Ba'al HaAitur and explains the sugya in Masech Megillah Daf Kaf over there, that Katan is Hayav Midei Rabbanan. Katan Patur Min HaMitzvot Min HaTorah is Patur. But Midei Rabbanan is Hayav. And Mitzvot Mikra Megillah, what is it Mitzvot Mikra Megillah? Midei Rabbanan. So now, is equal to Gadol. Gadol is Hayav Mikra Megillah Midei Rabbanan. And Katan is Hayav Mitzvot Chinuch Midei Rabbanan. At Midei Rabbanan, Hu Mafik Midei Rabbanan. So therefore, says Ba'al HaAitur, Katan can be the Megillah for the Gadol, and it's going to be Motzi Him Midei Chova. If so, according to Ba'al HaAitur, Sfirat HaOmer, nowadays, according to majority of the poskim, it's the Rabbanan. That's what the Ran says. Ran says, Rov ha-mifarshim sovrim, Sfirat HaOmer b'zman hazeh de Rabbanan. Tosafot also says, Sfirat HaOmer b'zman hazeh de Rabbanan, Masechet Menachot, Daf Samech Vav Amud Alef. Rosh also, Ne'el Masechet Pesachim, says Sfirat HaOmer de Rabbanan. So many poskim hold, Sfirat HaOmer nowadays, the Rabbanan. And the Katan is Hayab ha-mitzvot, Midin Chinuch, Midin Rabbanan. So now, he's not missing anything. When he was a Katan, he was Hayav Midei Rabbanan Midin Chinuch. And now he turns Bar Mitzvah as a Gadol, he's still Hayav Midei Rabbanan, Sfirat HaOmer Midei Rabbanan. So, he didn't miss anything. So you can continue with the Berachot according to Ba'al HaAitur. But the Svara of Ba'al HaAitur is not agreed upon all of the Poskim. Tosafot over there, Masechet Megillah Daf Kaf Amud Bet, saying that the level of the Hayav of Katan is different than a Gadol. Even on the mitzvah de Rabbanan. Megillah is de Rabbanan, right. But since Katan is Hayav de Rabbanan, even in mitzvah de Oraita, Matzah, on the first night of Pesach, is de Oraita. The Katan is not obligated min HaTorah, is obligated only de Rabbanan, midin Chinuch. So on mitzvah de Oraita, is Hayav de Rabbanan. On mitzvah de Rabbanan, it's considered that it is Hayav only mitre de Rabbanan, which means a lower level of Hayuv, a lower level of obligation. And Gadol is Hayav b'had Rabbanan. La ate t'rede Rabbanan u'afik had Rabbanan. Which means the levels of the Hayuv are not equal. The level of the Hayuv of the Gadol, even on mitzvah de Rabbanan, is much higher than the Hayuv of the child, of the Katan. So therefore, since he's on a low level Hayuv, he cannot be Motzi Gadol, which he is on a higher level of Hayuv. The Gadol, the Hayuv of the Gadol is called Hadir Rabbanan. The Hayuv of the Katan is called Treder Rabbanan. La Te, Treder Rabbanan, Wafik, Hadir Rabbanan. According to Tosafot, even if Sfirat HaOmer nowadays is the Rabbanan, still the first few days that he counted the Omer, he was Hayav only Betreder Rabbanan. And now when he turned Bar Mitzvah, he now becomes Hayav on the higher level of Hayuv, which is Hadir Rabbanan. And La Te, Treder Rabbanan, Wafik, Hadir Rabbanan. It's considered that he's missing the first few days of the mitzvah. Not only that, but we said that mitzvah chinuch, it's the Rabbanan on the Katan, that itself is not agreed upon over all the poskim. Rashi, Masechet Berachot Daf Memhet Amud Aleph, says, mitzvah chinuch, what we do to educate the children, to train them to do the mitzvot, it's not the obligation on the child. You cannot tell a child you're obligated. He's a child. He doesn't have the right knowledge that you want to obligate him to do something. So what is it, chinuch? Who is obligated to do the training for the katan? The father. The mitzvah of the chinuch is not on the child, it's on the on the father. The katan is not hayav, not midoraita, and not midrabanan. He has no hayuv whatsoever. The all hayuv of mitzvat chinuch, it's on the father. And the beginning of Masechet Chagiga, Daf Bet Amud Aleph, Rashi says over there that the mitzvah of the chinuch is on the father and the mother. He's including the mother on the mitzvah of chinuch. But the katan, you cannot mechayev the katan. No hayuv. Not the oraita, not the rabbanan. Similar to Rashi, it's a Rambam's opinion. Rambam, the Perek Zayin Halachot Lulav, says, what the Mishnah is saying, Katan ha-yodea le-na'anea, Aviv lokeach lo lulav. So Maran, the Kesef Mishnah over there is medek, Lashon Rambam, Aviv lokeach lo lulav, the mitzvah is on the father to make sure he's going to have a lulav. It's not the mitzvah of the Katan. The obligation is not on the child itself to get a lulav and to do the mitzvah of Arba'at Aminim. It's a Katan. The chinuch, the obligation of chinuch is on the father. The father is supposed to train him. And according to Rambam, it's understood very well. Why? Because how do we know who told us that we're supposed to listen to Hakamim? You're telling me mitzvah de Rabbanan. Who says to listen to the Rabbanan? The Torah itself told me that. I learned that from the Pasuk. Lo tasur min ha-davar asher yagidu lecha, yamin u-smol. The whole chiyuv that I have to listen to Chachamim comes from the Torah. And the Torah poter the Katan. The Torah says the Katan is patur. So how you want me to chayev the Katan with the Rabbanan? The whole chiyuv of the Rabbanan comes from the Torah. And the Torah says the Katan is patur. So you can't be chayev the Katan. You got it? The chiyuv to listen to divrei Chachamim comes from the Torah. Lo tasur min ha-davar asher yagidu lecha yamin u-smol. The Torah tells you to listen to Chachamim. So the obligation to listen to mitzvah de Rabbanan comes from the Torah. And Katan cannot be chayav min ha-Torah. The Torah says Katan is not chayav. So how you want to obligate the Katan to do mitzvah lo tasur? It's part of the package deal of mitzvot of the Torah. Tariag mitzvot of the Torah. One of them is lo tasur. And Katan is patur. So it's patur mit de Rabbanan also. Got to be that the chinuch, the mitzvah of chinuch, the obligation to train him to do the mitzvot is on the father, not on the katan itself. So now, according to Rambam and Rashi and many other Rishonim follows their opinion, the obligation of chinuch is not on the katan whatsoever. Not the oraita, not the rabbanan. So the first few days that he counted the omer, it was completely patur. It was completely patur. Now he becomes hayav in the middle of Sfirat HaOmer. It's a new chiyuv. Now it's a bar mitzvah. Now he has a new obligation. According to Baal HaChok Gedolot, he's missing Temimot. He doesn't have Temimot. He's missing the first few days of Sfirat HaOmer. So he cannot continue count with the Berachot. It's not simple. It's a mahloket. And we can say that we have a Safek Safika. What's the Safek Safika? Shemei Halacha Kerabbeinu Tam, who says that every night it's a mitzvah by itself. So I don't care that he missed the first few days. And even if you say Halacha Baal HaChok Gedolot, who says that Sfirat HaOmer, that Ba'inan Temimot, you need all the days to be counted, maybe the halakha is, according to Ba'al HaEtur, who says, the Katan, he is obligated on mitzvah chinuch, mid Rabbanan. And Sfirat HaOmer nowadays is the Rabbanan. So it's an Iko Hiyuv, according to Ba'al HaEtur. Same as he said, the Bat Megillah, that Katan Motzi Gadol, because it's an Iko Hiyuv. So according to his opinion, over here also, Katan has the Iko Hiyuv, that's the Rabbanan. Before it was Bar Mitzvah, it's the Rabbanan. And now after Bar Mitzvah, it's also the Rabbanan. And then he has the Temimot. So if you mitzaref the opinion of Baal HaEtur together with Rabbeinu Tam, you have a Safek Sfikah to allow him to come with the Berachot. What's the problem? The problem is that this Safek Sfikah is not Shalem. On the other hand, I have another side to say that the Katan is Patur. Even according to Baal HaEtur. And what is that? Since I have many opinions among the Rishonim who says that Sfirat HaOmer nowadays is Deoraita. Harambam, Perek Zayin Halachot Medin Musafin, in the end of the Perek, says Rambam, that the Hiyuv of Sfirat HaOmer, it's any time. There's no difference between the time of Beit HaMikdash or even after Churban Beit HaMikdash, there's still Chuvah to count the Omer Midoraita. Harif, in the end of Masechet Pesachim, the Poskim explained the opinion of Harif over there, that he holds also Sfirat HaOmer Deoraita. There's two Girsaot in Sefer HaChinuch, if Sfirat HaOmer Deoraita or the Rabbanan. There is a Ra'avaya, Rabbeinu Avi Ha'ezri, ben Rabbeinu El Levi, Mevi Oto Atur, Besiman Tav Petet, who says, Sfirat HaOmer nowadays Deoraita. So I have a Rambam, a Ra'avaya, Harif, and Shitat HaRa'ah, there is a Girsaot in HaRa'ah. And some other Rishonim that saying that Sefirat HaOmer nowadays, they're right. According to their opinion, even Balai too would say that Katan cannot continue to count after he became Bar Mitzvah. Why? When he was a Katan, he was Hayav, only me, the Rabbanan. And after he turned Bar Mitzvah, now he's Hayav, me, the Oraita. And Lekule Am, Alate, the Rabbanan, Umafik, the Oraita. So I have many tzedadim to say that Katan, who turned Bar Mitzvah in the middle of Sefirat HaOmer, cannot continue saying the Sefirah with the Berachot. And that's how Rav Hida is paskin, Rav Hida Berkei Yosef, B'Siman Taf Petet, he's paskin that Katan is not, once he became Bar Mitzvah in the middle of Sefirat HaOmer, he should count with no Berachot. He should be Yotzei Dehova from his father or from the Hazan with the Beracha, and then he can count for himself. Also, Gaon B'Chaim Palaji is paskin the same, that Katan is Patur. Sefer Shel Metzibur also paskin the same. Katan, who became Bar Mitzvah, once he turned Bar Mitzvah, Sefirat HaOmer is not going to count with the Berakha. But it's not agreed among all of the poskim. Some Ahronim says that he is Hayav, he can continue saying with the Berachot. This is a Hiddush of Sefer Or Letzion. Rabbeinu Ben Tzion Abba Shaul, Zecher Tzadik Yivracha. He says that even though we know that once he becomes Bar Mitzvah, he becomes Bar Mitzvah, he's Hayav min ad-din. When he was a Katan, he's Hayav midin Hayuch, midin Hinuch. He has Mechadesh that such a mitzvah that he started to do midin Hinuch. And now, in the middle of the mitzvah, there is a reason to say he's Patur, who will be Mechayev him midin Hinuch also. The Hiddush is that Gadol can be Hayav b'mitzvah midin Hinuch. The regular Tfisa is Gadol is Hayav min ad-din. Katan is Hayav mi-Hinuch. Hinuch is Shayach only to a child. The Hiddush of the Rav is Hinuch Shayach also for a Gadol. Adult also can be Hayav midin Hinuch. Where do we see a source for it? Rashi and Ramban, Parashat Ekev. On the second paragraph of Kiryat Shema, Ba'ayim Shema Tishmi'u. V'samtem et devarai ele, V'samtem et devarai ele, Ali Ravchim V'anafshichim. Rashi and Ramban, Rabbeinu Moshe Bar Nachman, they explain the Pasuk, when you go outside of Eretz Israel, don't leave the mitzvot behind you. Continue, fulfill the mitzvot, even though you are outside of Israel. Continue to do the mitzvot. Why? So you're not going to forget. When you're going to come back to Eretz Israel, you're used to it. You know the mitzvot. You understand the mitzvot. You know how to fulfill them. Do you realize what the Ramban is telling you over here? Our obligation outside of Eretz Israel to do the mitzvot is midin chinuch. Why are we obligated to do the mitzvot now? So once we're going to come to Eretz Israel, we're not going to forget them. We're not going to miss them. Yeah, keep doing the mitzvot outside of Eretz Israel. The Ikar of the Hayuv, where is it? In Eretz Israel. Don't, the Torah tells you. It's not the Rabbanan, it's the Oraita. The Torah tells you, keep doing the mitzvot outside of Eretz Israel. Why? So you're not going to forget them. Once you're going to go back to Eretz Israel, you're going to be able to continue to do the mitzvot. So the Torah is telling me a chidush over here, that the gadol can be hayav midin chinuch, like a child. We are like children on exile. Yeah? Bagola, we are considered the yaladim. It's also kav zchut also. Anachnu yaladim, ma rotzim meitanu? Level of chinuch. But we're learning a yesod over here, says Chacham Ben Tzion, that gadol can be hayav midin chinuch. Therefore, this child who started to do the mitzvah of Sefirat HaOmer, and he counted every day, Baruch Hashem, beautiful, he fulfilled the mitzvah. 2 weeks later, he turns Bar Mitzvah. What do you tell him? Till now, you were tzaddik, you did every day, you didn't miss any day. From now on, you lost it. The whole chinuch, to do the mitzvah, what's the purpose of the chinuch? To train him to be able to do the mitzvah later. And now he turns Bar Mitzvah, now he's hayav, and you're telling him, oh, stop. Now you can't fulfill the mitzvah with a berakha. He's missing. The idea of chinuch is missing also. Therefore, says Rav, he can continue to say the berachot midin chinuch. And here's a raya from Magon Rabbi Akiva Iger. Rabbi Akiva Iger is discussing a question. There is a halacha. The Torah says, ve'achalta, ve'savata, uverachta et Hashem Elokecha. Right? If a person ate bread, and he had enough bread, k'de sevi'ah, he's satisfied from the bread that he ate, he has an obligation to say Birkat HaMazon, shal aseh min HaTorah. Now, question of the rabbi is like this. A child, the day before his bar mitzvah, 5 minutes before he became bar mitzvah, he finished eating a full meal with bread, ve'achalta ve'savata. And he said Birkat HaMazon while he was a child. 5 minutes before sunset. And then, שקיעת החמה, צאת הכוכבים, he turned bar mitzvah. The mitzvot that he did while he was a child, patur, right? Let's take another example. Katan, a child, who the day of his bar mitzvah, in the morning, before he turned bar mitzvah in the morning, he got up in the morning, like every other day, he said, מודה אני, נטילת ידיים, ברכות השחר, and also ברכות התורה. He said ברכות התורה. You know the הלכה. What's the הלכה? We're not allowed to learn Torah without of saying ברכות התורה. עושה את הגמרא מסכת ברכות, מנני ברכות התורה מן התורה שנאמר, כי שם השם יקרא, הוו גודל אלוקנו. Before you learn Torah, you must say ברכות התורה. Let's say you get up at 3:00 in the morning, and you can't fall asleep. You want to learn something. What do you have to do before you're learning? You don't tell that time, and you say ברכות התורה. תרי ברכות, אשר קדשנו מצווה וציוונו על דברי תורה, וערבנו השם אלוקנו, ברוך אתה השם למד תורה לעמו ישראל, אשר בחרבנו בכל העמי, ברוך אתה השם נותן לתורה. This is the ברכות of ברכות התורה. ותאר שם ברכות התורה, מנה עלה תולון תורה. So the Gemara, עמה חרבה הארץ על עזבה מתורתי, ולזית עזבה מתורתי, שלא ברכו בתורה תחילה. Consider the Torah important enough to say ברכות before learning, and that causes the destruction of Eretz Israel. It's very strict. You cannot learn Torah without of saying Birkot HaTorah first. But the Birkot HaTorah that we say in the morning apply for the whole day, until you go to sleep. Until you go to sleep at night. If you slept in the middle of the day, it's not considered Shenat Keva, Shenat Arai. But if you slept at night on the bed, that's called Shenat Keva. You woke up again, you got to say Birkot HaTorah again. Or, another way you're going to be Hayav again to say Birkot HaTorah, on the next morning, like Shavuot night, we're staying up the whole night. After Alot HaShachar, it's a new day. We have to say Birkot HaTorah again. You have to stop to learning. We still have time to Shacharit. We're not starting Shacharit by Alot HaShachar. We're starting Shacharit maybe half hour later. So we have another half an hour to learn Torah. But we cannot learn Torah before saying Birkot HaTorah. We got to do Birkot HaTorah first. Now, let me ask you a question. This bar mitzvah boy, in the morning, he was still a child, right? He said Birkot HaTorah in the morning. After sunset, it's a new day, he turned bar mitzvah. Can he learn Torah now? Relying on the Birkot HaTorah that he said in the morning? The Birkot HaTorah he said in the morning, what was it? He was Katan. Katan is Patur. Now that he turned bar mitzvah at night time, now he's Hayav. How can he learn Torah? He got to get up and say Birkot HaTorah. He was patur in the morning. What's the solution for that? The solution is, when he says Birkot Kriat Shema of Arvit, the second bracha, Ahavat Olam Ahavtanu, what do we say over there? Aken Hashem Elokeinu, V'shochvenu V'kumenu, Nasi'ah B'chukecha, V'nismach V'na'aloz, B'divrei Talmud Toratecha, מצוותיך וחוקותיך לעולם ועד, כי הם חיינו ואורך ימינו, ובהם נהגר מה ולילה. We're basically talking about learning Torah over here. Yeah? Says Maran, שהב הכוונה to be יוצא ידי חובה and this ברכה as ברכות התורה also. And that's going to be applied for both. ברכות קריאת שמע and ברכות התורה. And therefore this Hatam Bar Mitzvah boy should not do Arvit early. On the summer days, we do Arvit before sunset, many times. But if he's going to do Arvit before sunset, he's still a Katan. He's not Yotzei Ydei Chova. He's going to have another issue, how he Yotzei Ydei Chova Arvit altogether. So he should wait till it's going to be Bar Mitzvah. After sundown, after Tzatek Kuchavim. Now he's obligated to do the mitzvot. Now he's going to do Arvit. He's going to say Birkot Kriyat Shema, have a Kavanah to be Poter also Birkot HaTorah. He's going to say Kriyat Shema Shel Arvit, that's going to be his first mitzvah deoraita that is fulfilling as a bar mitzvah boy. And then mitzvah tefillah, according to Arbaim, it's also mitzvah Aseh Minat Torah. Arvit will be his first tefillah mideoraita. And after 18, he should learn a few psukim. Maybe he can say Parashat Birkat Kohanim, because we need to attach Parashat Minat Torah to Birkot HaTorah. Limud Torah to Birkot HaTorah. That's the solution regarding Birkot HaTorah. It's not only for a Katan. This is situation happens a lot of times with a convert. Many times a convert, we're training him to do the mitzvah before he's converting. So he goes to shul every day. He puts the tzitzit. He puts the tefillin. He prays shacharit. He's doing mitzvah, fulfilling the mitzvah. The day of his conversion, in the morning he was in shul. He prayed shacharit, with tzitzit, tefillin, berkot ha-shachar, berkot ha-torah, kriyat shema, everything. And then 10 o'clock in the morning, he's scheduled to do the conversion. He goes to Bedin, and Bedin is taking him to Mikveh after he did Berit Milah. Berit Milah they do much before. So, but Milah is not enough. To complete the conversion, you got to do Tevilah in Mikveh, in front of three Dayanim, and to accept upon himself the Torah. Torah שבכתב, Torah שבעל-פה, מצוות התורה, מצוות הרבנן. He does it in front of בדין. גיור צריך שלושה, משפט, it's considered a משפט. So three דיינים, they're accepting him, 10 o'clock in the morning, he goes to מקווה, in front of בדין, he's accepting תורה ומצוות, מקבל עומר חוץ שמיים, מקבל עוד תורה ומצוות, אמונת השם, ייחוד השם, perfect. Perfect גיור. He goes out of the מקווה, first thing I did with the girl, I gave him a sidur. I said, say Birkot HaShachar. So he told me, Kvod HaRav, I said it in the morning. What's the answer?
You were not Jew.
You're patur. Well, go ahead, have to do Birkot HaShachar? Who told him to do Birkot HaShachar? You're not Hayav. We're just training him to do it, but he's not Hayav. And then I told him, listen, you got to put tzitzit and tefillin, do a shacharit again. He said, I did shacharit, I did tzitzit, I did tefillin, everything I did in the morning. What's the answer? Adoni, you were going before. Before you can dip to the mikveh, you were going. You're patur completely. Now you're hayav. Mazal tov. Baruch tiyeh. Hazak u'baruch. Now you're starting from Bereshit now. Take the sidur. Modei ani, berkot ha-shachar, berkot ha-torah, tzitzit, tefillin, shacharit, everything. Kriyat Shema. If the time of Kriyat Shema still did not pass. Okay. So it's hayav b'mitzvot. Whatever he did while he was patur does not count for him. So he does it again. Same thing here. With a bar mitzvah boy. He was a bar mitzvah, he was a child when he started to count the Omer. He was patur. All what he did was completely bepitur. Does not count for him. Now he turns bar mitzvah, now it's hayav. So whatever he did bepitur does not count for him. But here, Chacham Etzion comes up with this idea. Rabbi Akiva Iger, he has a hakira. What's the hakira? This child ate a meal 5 minutes before sunset. After sunset, he becomes obligated by mitzvot, high by mitzvot. He said Birkat HaMazon before Shkiat HaHama. A second before Shkiat HaHama, Asher Shalom Mirumah, Bahamad Shama Kama Yisrael Mu'amin. He finished Birkat HaMazon. Now, Tzet HaKuchavim, Mazal Tov, Hatam Bar Mitzvah. Everybody singing, Masiman Tov, Mazal Tov, Baruch Hashem, Hatam Bar Mitzvah, high by mitzvot. Does he have to repeat Birkat HaMazon or not? What's the question? What's the hakira?
Yes.
The Torah says, "Va'achalta, v'savata, uverachta." The obligation to say the beracha is on the achila or on the svi'ah. That's the hakira. If you would say the obligation is to say the beracha on the achila, he ate when he was a child, so it's patur now. The obligation is on the achila, and the achila was before sunset, so he was still a katan. It's patur. But if the chiyuv to say Birkat HaMazon is not on the achila, it's on the svi'ah, and now he's gadol, after Tzad HaKohavim is Gadol, and he's Savea. Let him say, Birkat HaMazon. That's the Hakira for going back to Eger. It's all about Chiyuv. Yeah? You understand the Hakira? What's the Chiyuv? The Chiyuv is on the eating, the part that he ate, that's the Chiyuv? If so, he's Patur. Why? Because he ate when he was a Katan. But if the Chiyuv is on the Svi'ah, when he's satisfied, now he's Gadol. He's satisfied as a Gadol. Satisfied as a Gadol? V'savata? V'yachta et Hashem Elokecha? See Birkat HaMazon? So Rabbi Akiva Iger is doubting. He's mistapek. The Chiyuv was on the Achila. The Chiyuv was on the Svi'ah. What was his case? What was Rabbi Akiva's case? That he already said Birkat HaMazon. He said Birkat HaMazon before sunset. But what's the issue? If the Chiyuv was on the Svi'ah, Birkat HaMazon that he said before sunset was as a pitur. It was a katan then. As a katan, it's not to say the Chova. Can it be Gadol to say Birkat HaMazon? You understand? And Agron Chacham Ben Tzion Abba Shaul is asking, why Rabbi Akiva Iger does not ask us the same question if he didn't say Birkat HaMazon altogether? He didn't say Birkat HaMazon before sunset. And now it's Tzedek Kochavim. Does he have to say Birkat HaMazon? He was on the Achila or he was on the Svi'ah? Says Leon Chacham himself, Rabbi Akiva Iger, there must be that if he didn't say Birkat HaMazon at all, it's for sure he has to say Birkat HaMazon. Yimar Afshach. Even if the Chiyuv was on the Achila, he's supposed to say Birkat HaMazon now that he's a Gadol. Me'ez Adin? Midin Chinuch. He was a katan, he was chayav b'chinuch to say Birkat HaMazon. Now he's a gadol, he didn't pay this chinuch. He was not poriah the chiyuv. So he would say Birkat HaMazon is a gadol also. The whole hakira of the Rav is, if he said Birkat HaMazon as a katan, now, if the chiyuv is on the svi'ah, he has a new chiyuv. Now he's a gadol. He is satisfied as a gadol, he's chayav to say Birkat HaMazon. What he said before, the Birkat HaMazon that he said before Shkia, is not Motzei Medei Chava because he was a Katan. So Chacham Mitzion is learning from Rabbi Akiva Iger that there is an idea of Chinuch on the Gadol also. So therefore the conclusion of Rabbi Akiva Iger is, of Chacham Mitzion Abba Shaul is, that Katan can continue count the Omer with the Berachot. It's a machloket between Maran Rabbeinu Avadei Yosef Alav Shalom. אין מה, הגאון הגדול, חכם בן ציון אבא שאול זכר צדיק לברכה, עליו השלום. These two great giants were arguing with each other if he can continue to say the ברכות of ספירת העומר, or he cannot continue to say the ברכות. אבן חכם עבדיה, עליו השלום, חזון עבדיה, he wrote in the end, אני לא מוחה בקטן שממשיך לספור עם ברכות. לא מוחה. If you ask me, I would tell him, count the עומר with other ברכה. What's the big deal? You could be a Tzedek Chova from the Chazan. Shomea, Ka'ane, listen to the Berakha, have him, remind him to have a Kavanah to be Motzi Yedek Chova. Either a Chazan, or your father, or your friend, you tell him, have a Kavanah on me, say the Berakha, I will answer Amen after you, and I'll count the Omer. I'll fulfill the mitzvah perfectly. I'm not going to miss anything. Shomea, Ka'ane. So I have a way to do the mitzvah with no safek. Why to get myself into a safek if I'm allowed to say the beracha? It's safek berachot le'akel. That's Chacham Avadiah's opinion. But Chacham Avadiah himself saying, if I would see a child, bar mitzvah boy, who was continued to say the berachot, I'm not going to stop him. Ani lo mochei b'yado. If he says the berachot, he says the berachot. Why? It is what to rely on. It's not completely a mistake to say the berachot. We saw there's a wide base to say, to allow him to continue the berachot. But if he's asking us, what's the better way to do? I will tell him, rely on the Hazan, rely on your father, let someone else to say the beracha for you. You will listen to the beracha, be it said the chava from him, and then you continue, you can count the Omer for yourself. Baruch Adonai le'olam, amen ve'amen.
You've just experienced another Torah class, brought to you by TorahAnytime.com.